My beloved brothers and sisters, every time we commence the Friday sermon, it is very important for us to commence with the praise of the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has created us, the nourisher, the cherisher, the sustainer, the provider, the protector, the curer, the one in whose hands lies complete control of entire existence. And it is also very important that we send blessings and salutations upon the chosen one and those who were chosen before him in terms of the messenger, peace be upon him, and the other messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One might ask, why is it so important to send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? My brothers and sisters, in Islam we are taught to be grateful and to show gratitude. To show gratitude to those who have been kind to us, to those who have done good to us, knowing fully well that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who allowed them to be kind to us. So gratitude actually belongs to Allah. But if we were to show the thankfulness and the gratitude in the correct way, firstly to the person in front of us who has done the goodness to us where we can physically witness it, it would be far easier and far more genuine when we thank the Maker, the Creator, who behind the scenes has actually facilitated that. Many times someone does good to us, it is easier to say thank you to that person. Jazakallahu khayra. May Allah recompense you with goodness. When we use the term jazakallah, we are referring to recompensing. May Allah recompense you. Recompense you with what? This is why it is important to say khayra after that. May Allah recompense you with goodness. Not with evil, not with something bad. Hence, if a person was to do bad to you and you told them jazakallah without saying the khayr, it would mean may Allah recompense you and fix you up in the same way that you have done bad to me. You follow the point? So it is very important to say jazakallahu khayran when someone has done good to you. But if you really want to thank Allah, it starts off by thanking the person, the people whom Allah has used for that goodness to come to you, subhanallah. My beloved brothers and sisters, the greatest gift that I have and the greatest gift that you who are seated here in this blessed masjid in Lekki, in this beautiful city of Lagos, in this lovely country of Nigeria, in this amazing continent of Africa, in this superb globe known as the world, to be honest, the greatest gift we have is the fact that we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one, the maker, the one whom we worship, he alone, the creator, and that we are part of the ummah or the nation that belongs to Muhammad, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So to recognize this gift is very important. Many of us have gifts that we don't recognize. Today I am looking at you, you are looking at me. Have you thought for a moment, what if I did not have eyes? If you were to close your eyes, and if you were to imagine that I'm never going to be able to open those eyes again, your world will turn upside down. So thank Allah for your eyes, your nose, your ears, your tongue, your lips, and everything that we take for granted. We should thank Allah for these things.
Inna fi khalqi as-samawati wal-ardi wa ikhtilafi al-layli wan-nahari la-ayatin li-ulil albab. الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذابا.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the creation of the skies and the earth, and the fact that those and whatever lies between them, and all the creation of Allah, in it there are signs for those with sound intellect, those whom they remember Allah, those who remember Allah often while standing, while sitting, and they ponder over the creation of Allah, saying, "Oh Allah, you have not created all of this in vain. Save us from the punishment of hellfire." Ameen. Those who ponder, they are the only ones who will recognize the greatness of Allah. When you sit and you think, what do you have? I had food, I have clothing, I have a home, whether it is rented or whatever it is. There are people who are worse. To be able to thank Allah, you need to ponder over the issue that you are grateful for. If you haven't recognized it, how are you going to thank Allah? When you thank Allah, Allah says, I will give you more, I will increase. If your salary today is 50,000 naira and you want more, Allah tells you how to get more. You firstly need to recognize that Allah has blessed you with that much, and thank Allah for it and keep working harder, and Allah will bless you with more in one of two ways. Either He will let you have a higher salary in figures, or He will give you greater blessings in the same amount. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. But for that you need to thank Allah, not to complain. Our lives have degenerated into a mere play where we are complaining day and night regarding favors of Allah He bestowed upon us. People are complaining about what? They will complain about the job they have. Others don't have a job. The salaries they have, others have less. The food they have, others don't have food. The shoes they have, the cars they have, the phone they have, everything they have. They will complain about absolutely everything. Who is showing gratitude and thankfulness to Allah? Where is the thanks to Allah?
La in shakartum la azidannakum wa la in kafartum inna adhabi lashadid.
If you show gratitude in the true sense, Allah says, I will grant you increase, I will give you more, I will give you more. Allah is promising. He uses the words in the Arabic language that are powerful. I promise you that if you are going to be grateful, you will definitely receive increase. The first thing you will get is contentment, calmness of the heart, because I'm thankful for what I have. The second thing you get, the pleasure of Allah. You will get more in so many other ways that Allah has promised. And Allah says, if you show ingratitude, you are ungrateful, there is no way that you will be saved from the punishment of Allah. He can take away what He gave you. So how do we show gratitude? When Allah gives you, obey the instructions of Allah. Primarily, that is great gratitude. Allah gave you energy. Are you using that energy to do haram? If you are, that is not gratitude. That is ingratitude. May Allah forgive us. My brothers and sisters, the greatest gift is Iman, and the fact that we are part of the nation or the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That is the greatest gift we have. How do we show gratitude? Number one, we thank Allah for it. Indeed, Alhamdulillah. All praise is indeed due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Didn't I say moments ago that when we start off the lecture of Jumu'ah or any other thing or matter of importance, we start off praising Allah in the name of Allah. That is how we commence. My brothers and sisters, I want to let you know something very, very interesting. The goodness we have in terms of believing in the Creator alone and the disciplined rules of the beautiful faith of Islam. Islam is a religion of discipline. Discipline. It will govern the way you talk and purify it and refine it to make you a beautiful individual. The way the expression on your face is, the smile, the way you will address your family, all of that came in to Islam as a way of life. Who gave it to us? Allah. So we thank Allah. Who did Allah choose to bring it to us? The Prophet, peace be upon him. So what do? We thank him too. How do we thank him? Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammadin wa barik wa sallim. Aw wa ashabihi wa barik wa sallim. O Allah, send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad, peace be upon him, his household, his companions, etc., etc. Bless them, O Allah. That is showing gratitude to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the angels, they bless the messenger, peace be upon him. O you who believe, send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the most befitting way. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. This is an instruction in the Quran. Send blessings. So what do? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every time we hear his name, right? We are following the instruction of Allah. O Allah, send peace and blessings upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Peace and blessings upon the messenger. Why? Because he was chosen by Allah. He brought the goodness to us. Everything we do, we owe him the thanks. And we owe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that gratitude. So this is why the hadith says, Man salla alayya wahidatan sallallahu alayhi biha ashra. Whosoever sends blessings upon me one time, Allah will bless that person 10 times as a result. Subhanallah. Hadith, sahih, no doubt. You want Allah to bless you? Well, send blessings upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Think about what you are saying when you are saying it. May Allah bless every one of us. Ameen. This all goes back to the fact that he was chosen. When Allah chooses from amongst us some to have virtue over the others in certain things, it is a test for the one who was given the blessing and for those who were not given the blessing as well. For the one who was given the blessing, the test is, are you going to worship Allah in a better way now that He has given you wealth, now that He has given you health, now that He has given you good looks, now that He has given you knowledge, now that He has given you a lovely wife and children or husband or whatever else it may be, are you going to get closer to Allah or is it going to make you haughty, arrogant, proud, where you don't know or you've lost how to speak to your spouse, etc. You are not grateful. There is no gratitude. What have you done? So this is why we say when Allah blesses you, it's a test for you, yes. And it's a test for those who don't have. Because when you look at others, do you thank Allah for what He has given them? We are sitting here in this beautiful city of Lagos, like I said. There are people who are extremely wealthy and people who are extremely poor. For both, there is a test from Allah. Are you going to get closer to Allah? Because my brothers and my sisters, true success is only on the day of judgment, when you get your book in the right hand and you are told to enter Jannatul Firdaus, then you can say, I have succeeded. Before that, there is no success that is guaranteed. Nothing. You can be the poorest person in the whole country if your relationship with Allah is strong. And on the day of judgment, you are called out to receive your book in your right hand. On that day, you will be higher than the richest of the rich who used to be in the dunya if they had lost their connection with Allah. So this world is temporary. The point I'm raising is the gratitude is important for both parties. By getting closer to Allah, use whatever Allah gave you to get closer to Allah, to prepare for the real life, the life after death, to prepare for the real eternal life, not this temporary, small, short life. The life on this earth is very short, maybe 60 to 70 years on average, if you are lucky and fortunate. Even if you lived it under a tree, you will be buried in the same grave as others were. Similar. As for the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who brought the goodness to us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every time we send blessings and salutations upon him, we are actually doing ourselves a favor. His rank is the highest. He is the highest in terms of the creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will have great gifts given by Allah on the day of judgment. The power to intercede, the first to enter Jannah, the first to be resurrected, etc., etc. Everything, it's beautiful. He is the highest. So by you and I not sending blessings, we have not decreased his value in any way. But when we send blessings, we are increasing our own value. And this is why there is a competition every Friday to send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, showing gratitude. But I have one complaint. What is the complaint? Sometimes we say beautifully, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we say beautifully, oh Allah, send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad, peace be upon him, his household, his companions, etc., etc. We say it beautifully. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammadin wa barik wa sallim, aw wa ashabihi wa barik wa sallim. We say it very beautifully. That means we are acknowledging that he is indeed the messenger of Allah who brought a message to us. But alas, sometimes our lives are led in a way that is very, very far from the teachings of the same messenger whom we are sending blessings and salutations upon. What type of hypocrisy is that? On one hand, I am saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and on the other hand, I am lying, I am cheating, I am stealing, I am deceiving, I am robbing, I am abusing, I am beating up, I am doing all sorts of wrong things, I am drinking, I am committing adultery. What else am I doing? La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. So the message I have for you today, my brothers and sisters, and it is for me too, let us become more conscious of the message, of the messenger whom we send blessings and salutations upon. If only by sending blessings and salutations you are getting a tenfold reward, imagine what will happen when you really follow that sunnah, when you really follow the Prophet, peace be upon him, in his actions, in his words, in everything that he did or said, and we try our best to follow the sunnah, imagine what type of a reward we will have. Many of us are guilty in our homes when the same messenger next to whose name we are quick to say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and rightly so, when he has said the best from amongst you is the one who is the best to his wife or to his family, we are terrible to our wives, we cannot stand them, but we are quick to say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are very fast to say Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, it's important to say that, but isn't it hypocrisy to pay lip service only? To some people, the respect of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is nothing more than lip service. Look at their lives. Look at their attitude. It is an attitude of ingratitude. Their lives are filled with dirt and sin, and that which is far not only from Islam but from any teachings of goodness. And they just keep on repeating sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is that lip service? In no way am I undermining the value of salah ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No ways. But all I am trying to stress is it's time to follow that Nabi. It's time to improve yourself. Imagine sitting with a cigarette and smoking, whether it is a cigar that costs $100 or a little cigarette that was given to you for free. Imagine you have a cigarette and you are smoking and you are saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I mean, what are you trying to achieve? What are you trying to achieve? Can you not give up that cigarette for the sake of Allah and His Rasul? But when the doctor tells you, you have to give it up, otherwise you will die, then you are quick to give it up. People tell me, why do you give the example of cigarettes? And I tell them the reason is the doctors give the same example. Subhanallah. If it is harmful for you, then it is correct for me from the pulpit to address that issue. Quit the bad habit. Some of us are hooked onto pornography. And people say, why are you talking about it in the masjid? Because it is a major disaster. Can you not stop for the sake of Allah and the same Nabi after whose name you say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Stop it. Stop it. It's more important than anything that you can think to stop the sin. Subhanallah. If you really love the messenger, peace be upon him, I challenge you to quit smoking. I challenge you. Prove your love. If you really love the Prophet, peace be upon him, I challenge you to fulfill the 5 salah a day with love. I challenge you. Do you love him? Don't lie. May Allah protect us. If you really love the messenger, peace be upon him, I challenge you to quit adultery, to quit the drinking and the gambling. I challenge you. That is true love. I want to follow what he is doing. what he taught, what he is saying. Over and above sending blessings and salutations, I will continue doing that, and I want to do it. My beloved brothers and sisters, do you love the messenger, peace be upon him? If you truly do, I challenge you to dress correctly. You know what is the meaning of correctly. I don't need to explain it. I challenge you to improve your relationships. I challenge you to respect your folks, your parents, to look after your relatives. I challenge you to spend wealth in the cause of Allah with respect. I challenge you. Why am I saying this? It's about time we presented the correct image of Islam. Islam is not just chanting things, saying things that you don't know and you don't understand. Islam is all about worshipping the Maker alone and disciplining yourself to lead the best life. خَيْرٌ النَّاسِ أَنْفَعُهُمْ لِلنَّاسِ. The same messenger after whose name we say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so passionately is he who said the best of mankind is the one who is most beneficial to the rest of mankind. La ilaha illallah. How much have you benefited mankind? How have you benefited your neighbors? He is the same messenger who said, "Man kana yu'minu billahi wal yawmil akhiri, fala yu'dhi jarahu." Whoever believes in Allah and the last day must not harm the neighbor. We are harming our neighbors. We are perpetrating heinous crimes. And we say, I believe in Allah. I believe in the messenger. Come on, it's about time we stop just lip service. When you say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your life needs to show that. I want to end by giving you one example. When you say to someone, I love you, or when someone says to you, I love you, sometimes you know about that love before they utter it and without them uttering it. Sometimes you feel the love, even though they have not said it, you feel it. And sometimes when they say it, you know they are lying. Why? Because they are claiming to love you, but they are harming you, hurting you, not looking after your interests, etc. No respect, no dignity, nothing. And they are claiming to love you. May Allah forgive us. We are doing something similar sometimes. We claim to love Allah, but what Allah said is not important to us. We claim to love the messenger, peace be upon him, but we cannot even get up for Salatul Fajr. La ilaha illallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'ani wa sunnah. Wa nafa'ani wa iyaakum bima fihima min al-ayati wal hikmah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب وخطيئة فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.